Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to show you my 5 favorite Visual Studio Code extensions when I'm working on Azure. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite, ou dans la description. Question that I got frequently is what tool I'm using. So today I'm spending this video to talk about my top 5 extensions in Visual Studio Code. I picked Visual Studio Code because it's a tool that is cross-platform, it's free, and a lot of developers are using it. Of course, this top 5 change depending on your focus, the kind of work you're doing. So today, I'm talking about my top 5 when I'm playing with ARM template or creating web app. So the first one doesn't really count, it's a given, because it will be installed by installing any other Azure extension. And this one is Azure Account. With it, you will be able to sign on in Azure directly from Visual Studio Code. You will have your In the bottom of your screen, you have your connection. You will be able to check what kind of connection you want. Another very interesting feature from this extension is when you open the command palette on Windows, it's Ctrl-Shift-P, and you type Azure, you will see many different functions. And the one I want to show you is open bash. There's a PowerShell 102 also in Cloud Shell. So what it does, it opens the Cloud Shell but in Visual Studio Code. So nice thing about Cloud Shell, it will keep your history forever. And also, it's very fast when you want to execute some functions, for example, here listing your resource group. However, when you want to work with files, let's say you want to validate an ARM template you're working on, the file must be up there or in a blob storage. It cannot be local on your laptop, for example. The first real extension in my top 5 is the Azure App Service. And why I picked that one is because a lot of developers that are using code are developing web app. This will ease the process of building a web app and deploy it. To install it, it's very simple. I will provide a link in the description or directly from Visual Studio Code, you click on the extension icon and you will be able to search the name of the extension. So here, Azure App Service, and you just click the install button. For me, it's uninstalled because it's already installed. When you have it installed, it will show you here a new icon, Azure. And with that, you will see all your subscription, you will be able to list your web app and even dig deeper and go see the app settings, the files, and the connection string. You could even restart it, deploy it, and tons of things. Very, very, very useful. The second extension I want to talk today is my new favorite, and it's Azure CLI Tool. It's my new favorite because I just discovered it recently, and it's awesome. You need to be in a file with the extension AZCLI. So that thing will work from there. So here it is, I am in a file with the extension AZCLI. Let's say you want to do a validation of an ARM template you're doing. So you will be doing AZ and then group, and then you have deployment, and then let's say you're not sure of what's possible, say okay, I want to validate it, and I don't know the parameters. So just doing that, you have all the parameters listed directly in Visual Studio Code. So perfect. What I need to do is, of course, I need to pass my template fly. And see, just like that, you could be up and running in a second. So while recording this video, I completely forgot to talk to you about one other feature, and it's the capability to execute a command directly from Visual Studio Code. So you just need to right-click and you have the run from editor or terminal. If you're doing it in the terminal, it will open a terminal and execute the command, just like that. And if you're trying to run it from the editor, it will pop up a new window, execute the command over there, and you will have the result ready to edit. The third extension I want to talk about is Azure Function. And that one is very useful because you always have a little something that you want to up there quickly to be able to run it. So Azure Function is perfect for that kind of scenario, and the extension go with it. So with this extension, Again, from the Azure icon, you have it here, same place where App Service was, you have Function. And then you will be able to create new project, and those project add new function and deploy in Azure directly from Visual Studio Code. Even more, if you have function already deployed, you will be able to navigate through your subscription, see your function, see the settings, and even see your logs. So that's really useful. That means that you could be tracking, reading the logs of your Azure function in Azure directly from Visual Studio Code in real time. So this is also very, very cool. And even more, if you install Function CLI, you will be able to run the function locally and debug it before deploying it in Azure. So the fourth extension I want to talk about, if you see my video, you saw that I'm using it a lot of time, is Azure Resource Manager Snipet. And that one is really useful. So you need to be in a JSON file. So let's go in a JSON file. Here I am. And by typing ARM, I will have my snippet list available to me. So let's say I want to create an empty ARM template. So I just click here and then I have it. I want to add a new resource. Let's say I want to add the functions. See what I just did here? So I will type ARM again, dash, and then functions RE. And if I type that, I already have the snippet. And now it's pre-selected multi-place. So if I look here, function name is available, is highlighted here and lower on line 35. And if I'm typing it, say, let's say I want to call it function test, it's editing at both place. And when I will do tab, it will switch to the next selection here, the server far name there, like that, until I'm done editing all the snippet. It's very powerful, and you could put your skeleton of your ARM template pretty quickly. The fifth one, the last but not the least, is the Azure Resource Manager tool. Let me show you what it does. So yes, you will have IntelliSense and you have completion. I will have a quick validation of my schema and some rules. So for example, here, it will mention that my variable is never used. Also, for example, if you have like a storage name, it could warn you that the name is too long. If I want to use my variable, I could go here. Let's say I want to put my function. So I will put it between square brackets and then I will just start typing variables and it will know my variables. So this way I could very quickly be set and ready to work. So you see how this with the snippet and the others, you will be able to deploy your Azure resources very quickly. So there it is, my top 5-6 extension for Visual Studio Code when you're working with Azure. It was really hard to restrict myself only to 5 extensions. So to help me, let me know what your favorite extensions are in Visual Studio Code, let's say to play with data in Azure or AI. See you next time. Until then, here another video of Cloud in 5 minutes. Thank you for watching.